We're here at the feeding station with our new friend Tamara.
Hi.
Tamara came down from Gurnee, Illinois, right?
Yes, sir.
And you got down here last week. You've been here a little over a week now.
Yes.
And came down with a group of about 50 people, right?
No. Just me.
Came down all by yourself?
Yes.
Nobody else? You connected with this church? You found out that this feeding station was here somehow?
And yeah, I just drove by.
Drove by and thought this looked like a great place to come in and help.
Exactly.
Now, you've got an interesting story because you told me that your work let you go, or you were done with work, I think is what you said.
Yep.
And because you are a nanny, and so when the school year was out, you didn't have to be a nanny anymore, is that right?
That's right.
Okay, and you've been doing that for a while, right? Like 3 years?
Yes.
Yeah, and before that, you told me that you taught somewhere.
Yeah, I taught in Indonesia for 3 years.
For 3 years in Indonesia. So a nanny for 3 years, Indonesia for 3 years, and what else?
Before that, I worked in Russia and the Philippines and China and Canada.
Doing what?
Working with kids, teaching, playing.
So, teaching and playing, were you with a mission organization or you just...
Yeah, each country was a different organization. Yeah.
Okay. So you just have a call in your heart to be a missionary and serve people and go all over the world and do whatever God calls you to do, and this week he called you to Joplin?
That's right. Okay.
So
glad.
What's been the biggest blessing for you about being down here?
How much God provides, how well he provides, and how quickly and at just the right moment he provides people to volunteer to help behind these tables, and he provides chicken and gasoline and barbecue sauce and potato salad and everything that we need each day. It's really exciting.
It's funny because yesterday at lunchtime we ran out of the sides, right?
Yes.
And at about 2 o'clock a truck pulled up with sides. Isn't that amazing?
I didn't know it was coming. And so then we had sides for dinner. And we have sides for lunch and dinner today.
Barbecue pork.
And for another, I don't know, several days. A week probably.
So it's amazing.
Yes.
So what's next after this for you? You talked about fostering or...
My job as a foster parent starts sometime, and when it's time for me to move in to that home, then I'll leave here and head to Joliet.
Okay. Amazing. That's a great story. If people are thinking about a trip like this to Joplin or to Indonesia or Russia or somewhere else, and they're afraid of something or some, what would you tell them? I mean, you're a young lady. You're courageous, I think, to go all over the world. You've inspired me. You've put me to shame. And so what would you tell people that are hesitant about doing things like this?
That God is big.
Okay.
He's really big, and he takes someone who used to be afraid of going away to summer camp for a week, in high school even, and he's just shown me that he is faithful, that he is my provider and my protector wherever I've been, I'm so thankful for that.
Okay. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.